Gamers is a really entertaining show, and I would honestly say that episode 6 was the most repetitive episode within the past few weeks, I would say, because even though I didn't hate this episode, I did find myself for a majority of it just kind of sitting there, not really laughing, not really bored, but just kind of feeling like, okay, we've seen this joke time and time again. So when the ending content came around, I was expecting, oh, this is going to be an okay episode and that's that. But they completely twisted what I thought was going to happen, very similar to how episode 1 ends, where I was like, oh, our main character is going to join the game club and we know where this is going to go. And I honestly thought that he was going to just reveal that he wanted to be her friend, and like, that's how all the misunderstandings will get even more shifted. And then he accidentally asks her out and she says yes, she wasn't really thinking what she answered him, which of course she wants to date our main character, Tendo that is, but she didn't really realize that was going to happen. The entire school was just like, what the fuck? I thought he was just going to ask her to be her friend. How they do the ending really makes up for the remainder of this episode for me. And like I said, I enjoyed the episode, but it really did feel very repetitive compared to a lot of the other episodes where I felt like they're really shifting a lot of the misunderstandings, and this episode felt a little bit more of the same. Which isn't necessarily a bad thing, because not every episode is going to top or stay amazing, in my opinion. I mean, when you're running for 12 episodes, you're gonna have a couple of episodes that have bumps here or there, but I really enjoyed the ending content. What I really like with the series is how the directing really amplifies the misunderstandings, but also how each character is thinking, because what I really like with the ending content is how you keep seeing the clock tick, but then it'll shift to a different character and you'll see the same second tick, pretty much, which is just showing you what each character is thinking before our main character asks out Tendo. And I really like that, because they not only shift each character's kind of like art and animation design, but also just the way they frame it, the way they execute it, it really does give you a sense of you're looking at a different character's mind, and then you also have the superb voice acting to back it. And I really enjoyed the ending content. With the remainder of it, it was fine. It was pretty much just, I felt that they were relying a little too much, like they had like this crutch that they were relying on for the past couple of episodes that they just kind of implemented into this one, where it just felt like it was more of the same. All the characters think each character is dating the other, and it's entertaining, don't get me wrong, but it was a little like, we need to do something to spice it up, and then the ending content came, and it spiced it the hell up. Like, I mean, I can't complain with the episode, because really, my problems were solved within the same episode that I had problems with it. And I think at the core, I think for 6 weeks in, the most issues I've had within the series have been solved within the same episode, so I don't really have major complaints. I mean, as a, like, quality-wise, from the presentation with the art and animation, even the sound design with the voice acting, it's all been fairly consistent with the story, I feel like, slightly getting better and better, and then it stalled, and then it, I think, just kind of, like, leveled out within this episode. And Gamers is fun. I mean, I still see some people who seem to be, like, watching it, but kind of are like, oh, the misunderstandings are just kind of getting dry and boring. Personally, if I was in your shoes, I wouldn't be watching it if I couldn't deal with this much understandings and it wasn't entertaining, but I find the misunderstandings entertaining, and when it does feel like they are getting a little repetitive, it's just like, it's fine to watch, it's not too bad. But Gamers is a fun show. I think the cast is interesting. I think it's going to be insane to see where ultimately this is going to go, if he's going to be able to backpedal and maybe they're not going to have a relationship, but I really do hope that they do keep it, because I feel like for the second half of this season, it would do really well to see how the misunderstandings will happen, where Amano is going to have a girlfriend that he didn't actually want, but he does want, but he actually just thought he was only good enough to be a friend. That would be really interesting. If they do completely backpedal away from this relationship, I hope they do something else as interesting. But I got pretty good faith that episode 7 will be an enjoyable episode, and really only time will tell. But not a whole lot to say with this episode. It was fun. It was a little repetitive in the same for the most part, but the ending content with the end really does shift and fix most of the problems that I've had. So I'm interested to see where this misunderstanding is really going to go, because every character just doesn't know what the hell is going on at the end of the day. The school is just like, what are we even witnessing? Similar to us as a viewer. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. What do you think of this insane episode, and how excited are you for episode 7 next week? Let me know, and before you leave, smack that like button to show your support. If you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe. So until next time, everyone, please take care and have a good one.